We'd ask all that are physically able to please stand. Out of the depths I cry unto thee, O Lord. Lord, hear my cry. Let thine ears be attentive to the voice of my supplication. If thou, Lord, should mark iniquities, Lord, but who could stand? But there is forgiveness with thee, that thou may be feared. I wait for the Lord, my soul waits, and in his word I do hope. My soul waits for the Lord, more than those who watch for the morning. O Israel, hope in the Lord, for the Lord is a great mercy. With him is plenteous redemption, and he will redeem Israel from their sins. Comfort. Comfort your people. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and cry, for she has served her term and her penalty is paid. She has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice cries out in the wilderness, prepare ye the way for the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley should be exalted, and every hill and mountain shall be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the crooked places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all the people shall see it together. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken. A voice says, cry out. And I said, what should I cry? All people are grass. Their constancy is like a flower in the field. The grass withers and the flower fades when the breath of the Lord blows upon it. Surely the people are grass. The grass withers and the flower fades, but the word of the Lord shall stand forever. Hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard? The Lord is everlasting, God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint, and to them who have no might, he increaseth strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young shall fall and be exhausted. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles, run and not be weary, walk and not faint. Anyone who has not had an opportunity to view the remains, this will be the last opportunity before we close the casket and begin our worship celebration. Amen.
Amen. We are gathered here today to celebrate the life and legacy of Sister Grace Mason. And I say celebrate because if you knew Sister Mason, she was a praiser. Amen. Check, check, two, two. Yeah, she was most definitely a praiser. When she sang in the choir, she was a praiser. When she wasn't in the choir, I know I could look two rows in front of that camera. Amen. And you better have the tambourine on her seat, or it was going to be a problem. And so we are here to celebrate the life and legacy. My name is Johnny Simpson. I serve here as senior pastor at Faith United Methodist Church. And I had the pleasure since 2017 of being Sister Grace's pastor. The program will proceed as printed. If you see me get a little short, please don't charge it to me as being a mean person, but we have a hard burial time. Amen. We have a hard time to get to the cemetery for a burial. So the program's going to proceed as printed. If anyone needs, please raise your hand. The funeral directors will get one to you. The Old Testament and New Testament will be read by Reverend Walters. Then the prayer of comfort and musical selection. There's a video that'll play during the obituary reading. We have some resolutions to acknowledge, and then we'll get to expressions of love, another selection in the eulogy. But we are going to celebrate this time in the Lord. Amen? Amen. Let's hear ye the word of the Lord from Reverend Walters.
Thank you. Praise the Lord, everyone. The Old Testament reading today will be coming from the book of Isaiah, chapter 40, starting at verse 28. And the word of God reads, "Have you not known? Have you not heard? The everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, never faints nor is weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the weak and to those who have no might. He increases strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength, and they shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint." The New Testament reading will be coming from the Gospel of John, chapter 14. "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions, and if it were not so, I would have told you to go. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also." This is the word of God for the people of God. Amen.
Let us pray. O Lord, our God, how excellent is your name in all the earth. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, your name is great and greatly to be praised. Lord God, we thank you for the life of Sister Grace. We thank you for the love she shared, the people she made laugh, the people that knew they were loved by her, and we thank you for the life that was well lived, Lord God. Lord God, we know that before we could ever call Sister Grace ours, she was yours, and that we were simply at this time offering her back to you. Lord God, we know that birthdays and Christmases and Thanksgivings and Mother's Day are going to be a little different going forward, Lord God. But remind us that weeping may endure for a night, but joy shall come in the morning. Remind us to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. Remind us that she is in a place where there will be no more crying, and wipe away every tear, Lord God. Comfort us, speak tenderly to us. Remind us that you are God and God alone, Lord God. Lord God, comfort us in these coming days. Be with us and let us know that many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord will carry us through, Lord God. Help us to hold on to you in these times and know that we are loved. And not only that we are loved, Lord God, but that nothing can separate us from this love. No height, nor depth, nor things present, nor things to come. Be with the family at this time, Lord God. Help them hold closer together. It is in the name above all names that we submit this prayer. The one who can do exceedingly abundantly above all we could ever ask or imagine. The one that sits high but looks low. The one that speaks and universes are formed, but you know the number of hairs on our head. It is in that name, the Bishop of Souls, the Rose of Sharon, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the wheel in the middle of the wheel, that we submit this prayer. Amen, amen, and amen.
Thank you.
by yourself, but don't cry, Better days are coming, amen? Beautifully done. I have a resolution from Faith United Methodist Church, and it reads, "We, the members of Faith United Methodist Church, Dickinson, Texas, extend our heartfelt love and sympathy to the bereaved family on the passing of your loved one, Grace Mason, graciously transitioned from this earthly life on June 16, 2022, surrounded by her loving family. Whereas from her union of marriage to Oscar Mason, four children were born, Michael, Catherine, Melvin, and Raymond Mason. Whereas she was preceded in death by her parents, Annie and Lester Peterson, son Michael, sister Julia. She will forever be remembered by her husband, Oscar, children Catherine, married to Ron Jean Lewis, Melvin, with Cheryl Mason, and Raymond Mason, and her grand and great-grandchildren, family, friends, and church family. Whereas Grace loved her church, and especially singing in the choir, shaking her tambourine, you could see the smile of joy on her face as though she was singing for the King, her Lord and Savior. Therefore, let it be known that we know the deep loss and sorrow your family is experiencing. We want to share in your sorrow, but recognize that the Lord has accepted into his presence a good and faithful servant. Be it further resolved that Christ Jesus gives the assurance in Deuteronomy chapter 31, verse 8, the Lord goes before you and will be with you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. Trust in him and receive comfort and strength. Trust in his word. Receive the peace and comfort he gives." Comforting words from David M. Romano. "When tomorrow starts without me and finds your eyes filled with tears for me, I know how much you love me as I love you. But when tomorrow starts without me, please try to understand that Jesus came and called my name and took me by my hand. He said my place is ready in heaven far above, and that I have to leave behind all those I dearly love. So when tomorrow starts and you think of me, I'm right here in your heart." Humbly submitted this 23rd day of June 2022, Reverend Johnny Simpson Jr., Senior Pastor, Reverend Deidre Walters, Associate Pastor, and Doris Woodland, Worship Chairperson. Amen. We also received a resolution from the Greater Barbers Chapel Church, resolution of remembrance for Sister Grace Marie Mason. And the resolution reads, "We little knew that day that God was going to call your name. In life, we loved you dearly. In death, we do the same. It broke our hearts to lose you. You do not go alone, for part of us went with you the day God called you home. Sister Grace Marie Mason laid down the working tools of this life, answered her master's call, and went to her heavenly home where time is eternity." Resting in the words of 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 7, "I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith." Whereas we, the pastor, deacons, and members of the Greater Barbers Chapel Baptist Church, wish to express our sympathy to the Mason family. We want you to know that our hearts are with you as you gather in humble submission to the will of God, to bid a Christian farewell and goodbye to your loved one, Sister Grace Marie Mason. Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1 reminds us, to everything there is a season, a time for purpose under heaven. Whereas we pause today to remember Sister Mason, we must extend heartfelt condolences to her son and daughter-in-law, our faithful, devoted, and dedicated members, Brother Melvin and Sister Cheryl Mason. Brother Melvin and bereaved family, we understand and realize you have lost one of your most treasured possessions, a wife, a mother, grand and great-grandmother. Please know that we are here to support you and pray that God will sustain you and your family today in your hour of need and the days ahead. Whereas we offer this condolence, being fully aware that God will supply all your needs, be your helper, and provide the support needed during these trying times. We also realize that earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. Psalms 147, verse 3 reminds us, he heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds. Be it resolved, we embrace the family because all of us have a common bond that will connect us for the rest of our lives. As the days ahead may be trying, we encourage you to take comfort in Psalms 55, verse 22. Cast thy burden upon the Lord, and he shall sustain thee. He shall never suffer the righteous to be moved. Resolved, it was not long before life's precious hours were flying and the day of victory was nearing. It came to pass that after 94 fruitful years of love and devotion to her family and church, Sister Grace Marie Mason's earthly journey came to a peaceful end. Fulfilling the dream that the Lord gave and the Lord hath taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Job chapter 1, verse 21. Resolve that a copy of this resolution will be presented to the family and a copy placed in the church records this 23rd day of June, 2022. Pastor Kenneth L. Cotton, Barbara Baines, church clerk. A copy of the resolutions will be given to you. Amen.
Amen. Now we come to the part of the service where we have expressions of love. You'll notice right next to it, it says 3 minutes, please. So 3 minutes, please. If you want to speak, please start lining up to my left, your right, to this microphone over here. But, you know, we want to be mindful of the time, and I'll save you a couple minutes. No need to establish protocol, amen. I'll do it first, giving honor to God, who's the head of my life, and his darling son, Jesus Christ, and all the ministers and pastors on the roster. Good morning. That'll get you a minute in, amen. It's good to talk at the funeral, and it's good. I will say that. But I also want to ask to not just talk at the funeral, but talk to the family in 2 weeks. Amen. Because in 2 weeks, everybody's bereavement leave is up. And they got to go back to work. And everybody else will have thought and they've gotten over it. But they haven't had their first Thanksgiving yet. Or Christmas. Or Mother's Day or birthday. So if anyone feels led to speak at this time, please come to the podium to my left, your right. Those who have expressions of love. If you get a little close to your time, you'll feel a little help, right? Amen. and then a little longer. Amen. And if I have to stand up, that means it's your time to sit down. Amen. So please, at this time, those who have a desire to speak, please come at this time.
Morning, family. I really don't have very much to say besides that Grace was a God-fearing woman. We all know that. And as a child that has gone through this, I'm going to let you know it's never going to be easy, but it's going to be tolerable. You'll be able to tolerate it, and it will get more adjustable. But it's okay. It's okay. We go on and we move on. And you have my love. You have the love of my family, your cousins, forever. If you need anything from us, we're right there. 2:00 in the morning, my phone still works. So that's all I have to say. And for everyone else, just hold on to God's hand. That's all I have. Thank you.
Good morning. On behalf of the family, I want to thank everybody for coming. Just taking this as a last moment to say I love you. Amen. I didn't think I could do this, but I can hear my mama right now in the choir saying, get up, you boy, you better say something. So here I am. Mom was a woman of faith.
Yes.
She always had my back.
Yes. It's all right.
I can remember. I'll be brief. My mom was a woman of short words, so. When I was a little boy, I remember the first year I played little league football. You guys been around enough, we were the Dickinson Vikings. And I can remember waiting for my time to go in, and I go in to play first time, and my very first play, the referee blows the whistle and calls clipping on me. And, you know, I can hear the other parents, you know, encouraging, and they're like, hey, don't worry about it. And I could look over there and see my coach shaking his head, saying, no, we didn't practice that. But here's mama in the crowd, and according to her, I scored a touchdown. Scored a touchdown every play, according to her. But that's who she was. She had my back. And she taught me that God has our back.
Yes.
Am I missing? Am I missing? She loved the praise of her God. She loved this church. And my mama carried on.
your spirit will lift. Thank you.
Amen.
Well, I think Raymond kind of said it all. Your mom was our, she was our rock. Yeah, she did everything for us. It's just amazing grace, just as the song goes. She's just, it was amazing. Even the, in her last few days, even though this all took us by surprise, she made sure that she took care of everything there at the house. And even my dad, he's used to her, cooking for him every day and that type of thing. And she had two full meals ready to go and last him for a couple, 2 or 3 days, All this was done, the day before she passed. And it's just like she just took care, of everything there. Anytime I had a graduation or work function or school function growing up, she was always there for me, as well as my brother and my sisters, or my sister rather. She was just there, full of life, always smiling, always had a smile on her face, always greeted everyone with Jesus' joy. And she just was a very wonderful person to be around. And if you knew her, you knew she was full of life all the time. And I'd like to say that that's been passed on to us. We hope to continue to carry her torch for years to come and act as she would have liked us to act, and as be ourselves the way she taught us. She prepared us very well, and I'm appreciative. I'm sure my brother's appreciative. My sister's appreciative. Thank you all for coming.
Amen. Blessed are the pure at heart, for they shall see God. I sat back there and I thought for a minute, I'm not going to get up. But I kept getting this little tug, and I said, I have to get up. Miss Mason was my second mother. Miss Mason was my babysitter. How could I sit down on that? Blessed are the pure at heart, for they shall see God. She was a blessed woman. Her children have been blessed because of the mother that she was. She exampled nothing but the goodness of God in her life, me growing up and seeing her and seeing Kathy and Melvin and Raymond and Michael. They were all blessed because they listened to their mother. We all get off course every now and again, but when you listen to your parents, you get back on. Just like listening to God, you get back on track. And I just thank God for this family. Kathy and I were like sisters. And whenever I would get off the bus, my mom would always say, go to Miss Mason's house. And I would go to her house until my sister came home. And I love you, Kathy. I'm here for you. Hadn't seen you in moons, but I still love you. Melvin and Raymond, I love you. God be with you. I'll be praying.
Anyone else at this time? I do want to take this opportunity to acknowledge any other clergy in the audience. I see former council member, former Mayor Pro Tem King in the back, also the police chaplain and others at this time. Are there any other clergy in the room at this time? Oh, I see Pastor Renee as well. Thank you. God bless you for coming. We will now be led in a musical selection, and then the next voice you will hear will be the eulogist, Reverend Lorraine Brown, my predecessor here at Faith United Methodist Church, my intern mentor and mother in Christ. Amen.
Amen.
But then we will go as proceeded, as printed. Amen.
She was free in the house of the Lord. And Raymond, I say to you, yeah, Grace loved the tambourine, but she loved her hugs. If Grace would come in fussing at me on Sunday morning, all I had to do was get up and hug her. And she would just melt. We became so heart friends. I say hello, Dickinson. It's good to be here.
not under the conditions, but it's good to be in your presence. Our scripture for this morning is from Revelation 21, verses 1 through 7. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. They will be his peoples, and God himself will be with them, and he will be their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, for the first things have passed away." And the one who was seated on the throne said, "See, I am making all things new." Also, he said, "Write this, for these words are trustworthy, and they are true." Then he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give water as a gift from the spring of the water of life. And those who conquer will inherit these things. And I will be their God, and they will be my children." The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Eternal and almighty God, we come, O Lord, with broken hearts. But we ask that your word, Father, will bring comfort, bring strength, and definitely give us hope. So may the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts, O Lord, our God, be acceptable unto you. In the name of Jesus we pray, amen.
Amen.
Friends, we have gathered here to celebrate and remember the life of Grace Marie Mason. I know it's always hard to say goodbye, but it is easy to celebrate grace. Yes. There's part of me this day that says 94 years is a good life. Grace certainly didn't get cheated in the length of days and years. I say we ought to celebrate that, and we ought to be glad today as we send Grace off to the Lord our God. We ought to be glad that she had so many years and that she is now whole and healthy. But then there lies the contradiction of a funeral for a person like Grace, who did live a good life and a long life. On the one hand, we know this was not a life cut short. It was a life lived to completion. We know that we have much to be thankful for. There was so much good in Grace's life. She was a woman of integrity. She was gracious, loving, authentic, courageous, faithful, unshakable, and steadfast. We know that this life has now met its right and appointed end, and that Grace has left the weakness and the suffering of this world and gone on to a glorious place. It sounds like it's a happy ending to a fairy tale. She lived a good long life, then she lived happily ever after. Yes, that is to be celebrated and rejoiced about. That makes the laughter and the singing and the dancing be all there. But this happy ending is tinged with sadness, because Grace goes on to live happily ever without us.
Yes, yes.
It's so hard to say goodbye, so painful to be separated from her. We find sadness and gladness, joy and sorrow, laughter, and tears all mixed together in our hearts this day. And as we say goodbye to Grace, we especially want to take the time to celebrate and remember the life that we shared with her. When we spend time remembering and celebrating, hope does come into our midst. Memory strengthens our faith. But if we fail to remember, we forget, and in our forgetting, we become hopeless. It is in our remembering, it's in our celebrating, that we realize that hope truly is alive. And it is in our forgetting that we lose faith and we lose hope for tomorrow, and we lose the strength to stand in the midst of unrest. So we remember today. Though we mourn the absence of Grace's physical presence with us, this is a thankful service of remembrance. We can be thankful and celebrate that God is truly caring for Grace. Thankful and celebrate how God is caring for you, and he has for almost all of your lives by giving you the gift of Grace and giving you her life. This gift that we talk about that God gave us in Grace, it's not gone. Nothing, not even death, has really taken Grace away from us. The memories, the good times, the love that you have for Grace are yours forever. So let's thank God today for his love, for giving us Grace and giving us all of this life and years that he gave us. You see, bearing the cross, being a Christian, that was Grace's thing. God wants us to love each other and to praise him today and always. And as we join together in this day, giving witness to our faith, we realize that death doesn't have the last word. "I am the resurrection and the life," said Jesus to his friend Martha, whose brother had just died. And he continued and said, "All who believe in me, though they die, yet shall they live. And whoever lives and believes in me, though they die, yet shall they live. And whoever does believe in me and live in me, they shall never die." And then he said, "Do you believe this, Martha?" And Martha responded, "Yes, Lord, I believe." These words, "Yes, Lord, I believe," they would have been the words of Grace. She believed that all who believes in the Lord her God, though they die, yet shall they live. She believed it, and this day she is truly living it. We can truly celebrate because we know that Grace now lives with her Lord. Grace was something special. She was a law model Christian woman. Grace's heart was always filled with the gift of living life to its fullness. I would think it's safe to say that Grace's life was one that was made into a dance, into a joyful heart filled with song and praise. Grace was one of those unique people. We all came to know her, and we all came to love her. Grace could live with a joyful heart because she knew that she would live throughout all eternity. She knew that life on earth in the bodily form would end, but she knew the end of life on earth was only the beginning of a new life, life with her Lord and her Savior. Grace is an example to us of having fully lived the years that God gave her. Not with all the riches of the world or the fortunes of this world is not what Grace lived with, but she lived walking and living in the love of Christ Jesus, which is more precious than all the riches that this world could ever offer us. Her life was full, it was complete. In fact, Grace's life together along with yours was a life in which there was a season for everything. There was a time for every matter under heaven, Ecclesiastes 3 says. and those who knew grace and those who are offering you support through this difficult time. Know all well that there have been many times to weep and many times to mourn. There were struggles to face, losses to deal with, confrontation with personal illnesses. And yes, there were pain, time of pain and anguish for grace. Yet too, there have been times of joy, times of laughter, times of wellness and singing and dancing to her Lord. Grace knew that God did not promise us a rose garden, but she knew that he would always be present with her as the master gardener. Friends, if we are to live all of our lives, we are to endure the complete journey of good times and also the not so good times. We must acknowledge that the future, our future and the world's belong to God and God alone. Grace was a person who, because of her faith, because of her love, because of her connection to the church, she showed us by example what it meant to sing and to praise and to worship God all through life. Grace was a dedicated member here at Faith United Methodist Church. She loved making a joyful noise unto the Lord. I remember when I told Grace it was okay for her to have a tambourine. We used to be a little quiet in here, you know, until that radical woman ended up coming. But when I told her she could have a tambourine, she had it every Sunday. But I'm here to tell you that Grace was a great support to the church, and she was definitely a support to the pastor doing worship service every Sunday. She was always behind me in the choir. I was at Faith for 12 and a half years, and I tell you, I can count on one hand in that 12 and a half years that Grace wasn't singing in the choir and praising her God on every Sunday morning. And if church went on and Grace wasn't here, I couldn't wait to get out because I had to find Raymond and Kathy and see what was going on. Because I knew something was wrong. But I knew Grace had my back always. She kept mine too, Raymond. But you see, these past 24 months past seemed to have silenced the singing and the dancing for us. It silenced it for Grace and worship because we couldn't come together. The pandemic stopped all of that for us. But the good news for us today is that Grace's voice and Grace's dance is no longer silenced. Listen, can you hear it? I hear the tambourines are ringing. Listen, she's singing in the heavenly chorus. Listen to those who once sang on earth and now they are singing in heaven. Listen, I hear her saying, it is well. It is well with my soul. Can't you hear her singing? Grace is singing to the Lord. The Lord Jesus has now returned to the voices to those who were not strong, who was not able to sing. He's made them stronger. He's made the voices clearer. He's made them richer than they ever were before. She can truly make that joyful noise. Listen to them as they use these instruments, the tambourine. Listen. God created these things to make a joyful noise and the joy and the praise that we give to him. Because I tell you, church, if you don't praise him here on earth, I don't know how you think you're going to get to heaven and all of a sudden you're going to start saying glory, glory, hallelujah. Grace was also a dedicated member in my weekly Bible study. And you know, I cooked cookies weekly. Cookies was my ministry when I was here. I haven't cooked any since I left, okay? And Grace knew she wasn't supposed to eat any of those cookies. So she would always tell me that she was getting cookies for you, Mr. Mason. Now, I don't know how many you got and how many you didn't, but I learned to start sending some extras for you on Wednesday evening. Grace reflected the goodness of God and the joy that she found through her praise and her worship. She didn't let anything stop her from praising the Lord. And Pastor King, she always gave you praise. She always would say, Pastor King took care of me when nobody else wouldn't. Pastor King did the service for her son, Michael, and she never stopped being thankful for that. One of the greatest memories that we all carry with us today is the privilege of having been there to see Grace in this life, to share this life with Grace, to share her joyful, enthusiastic praise and her dance before the Lord. And I pray, Faith, that you keep that dance before the Lord going. Yeah. Now listen to these words again that I read from Revelation 21:1-7. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth. The first heaven and the first earth had all passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, I saw the new Jerusalem coming down out of heaven from God. It was prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, see, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them, and they will be his peoples. And God himself will be with them, and he will be their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. Oh, and death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, and the first things have all passed away. And the one who was seated on the throne said, see, I am making all things new. And he also said, write this down, for these words are trustworthy and they are true. Then he said to me, it is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. And to the thirsty, I will give water as a gift from the spring of water of life. And those who conquer will inherit these things, and I will be their God, and they will be my children. You see, the end often makes us think of the beginning. This scripture that helps us to see that the end of the Bible brings us face to face with the beginning of eternity. The passage speaks about the newness of life. What we can gain from this scripture is that the end, this is not the end for Grace, but it is the beginning. It is the beginning of life eternal. The light of the resurrection of Jesus and the resurrection of all of Grace's sisters and brothers to eternal life is truly the light of the resurrection that overcomes the darkness of death. Our scripture gives us a flash of a blinding light in the darkness of death. Grace has truly entered the holy city. She is sitting in the new Jerusalem, and God dwells there with her. Can you picture Grace in this new Jerusalem? Oh, she's talking. She's there where all things have been old, has been washed away. Where she has met God and he is wiping away all her tears and all her pain. There is no more hunger for anything in Grace's heart. And her soul will thirst no more. And she will not experience any more complications from diabetes. She don't have to worry about it anymore. Grace now resides in the heavens above, and God and all the saints that have gone on before her are there worshiping, singing, and praising. You know, they say when we get to heaven, they praise all day long. Oh, what a joyful time to sing and praise in the presence of the Lord your God. Yes, family, our lives will change without the physical presence of grace. But what is more important for each of us today is to know that the love that God has for each of us, the comfort, the strength, and the hope that God brings to us, it does not change. It's always constant. It is dependable, and it is certain. God is with us. Yes, you'll go through the valley of darkness, but you don't have to fear because you don't go alone. The Lord, your God, has already walked it, and he's walking it with you. God can renew and repair our lives that have been disrupted and broken by sorrow brought on by grace's death. Our God is truly a God of renewal and restoration. God looks among each and every one of us. He gives us life. God saves us from the power of death. And even in our sorrow, I say to you, let us rejoice this day in the promises of the gospel. Let us rejoice in the assurance of the resurrection and eternal life. And I say, as for today, let us look forward to the time of the reunion that we will have with grace in the heavens above. For nothing can separate us from the love of grace. No powers, no principalities, no depth, no height. Nothing can separate you from the love of grace. And if you walk in the Spirit, then you are connected with grace, because grace is in the spiritual realm. And she lives with her Lord and her God. And I'm going to keep on praising him. I don't know about you. And I'm going to keep on saying a little glory. Glory, hallelujah. I praise God for grace, because she taught me how to praise him and how to be free. She taught me how not to worry about what the world may say, but to let them know that God is worthy. He's worthy to be praised. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen.
Will now be in the hands of the funeral home. We'd ask all that are physically able to please stand. Shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness for thy name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table for me in the midst of my enemies, anointest my head with oil.